Thank you very much, Daniel. And now we have the third and last case. It's a client case from the company ProAcoustic. And it will be presented by a passionate violin player. So maybe the most romantic neo-score developer. Please welcome on stage Bernhard Schmidt.
So, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Bernhard, and I will try to hurry up a bit, although this might be considered unromantic. This is about multi-client solutions in Neos, which means in your average project, you will most probably have some kind of company that presents content to their customers. And in these projects, I will be showing you there's another step in between. So you have a union of companies. Their clients are the companies, and their clients are the end users. So about myself, I'm Bernhard Schmidt. I'm working at Corfia in Hannover currently. And I also joined the Neos team 1.5 years ago. The project setup. So there's the customer. It's they're called ProAcoustic. They're the union of audiologists in Germany. So if you are now asking yourself, what is an audiologist? As we are all getting older, and some of us visit the disco and other loud places a bit too often maybe, we all get into that situation where we visit an audiologist who then informs about hearing aid products, configures them correctly, and then sells them to us. The teams at Corfia, we had the arbitrary amount of people here, conceptors, designers, project management, and around about 4 developers. So sometimes 3, up to 5, but 4 on average. So the challenge was to implement a platform that allows members of said union to implement their own website and shop with absolutely minimal effort. Because as you may already know, if you look at the average audiologist in your hometown, some of them, or most of them, might not want to put the necessary resources into their own website. And that's exactly where the union steps in. So the idea was that the union provides both the platform for all those websites as well as the main part of the content. And the members may then change that content, add new content as they wish, and adjust their own website as they want. Something's happening. So each member joining the platform should start with a fully fledged website. So they just sign up, click some buttons, add their personal information, about contact stuff and so on, and they're ready to go. And of course, also the looks of the website should be adjusted as well. So there's some configuration options for a color scheme or logo. So the technical solution for this, as we're using Neos, is that we create some kind of master site and then add variants of that master site using content dimensions. So when we talk about content dimensions, that's usually language or in more exotic cases, something like country or market. In this case, the content dimension we used was actually audiologist. So there's one master site as the fallback, and for each member of the union, a new content dimension value is added. So they can override content. And if the union publishes new content of their own, this is automatically published also to all member sites. For this to work, we also had to implement a custom source and dimension and detection mode for dimensions. So we used domain for this. So each time a domain was added to the Neos backend, a new content dimension value was added as well. And the content dimension detection mode dimension was added so that on each request, the domain was evaluated to see which member to be shown. So the final thing we did before letting all those editors loose on the Neos backend was restricting them to only be able to edit their own website and, of course, preventing them from editing the other members' profiles in their own variants. And there's one little anecdote to be told about this. One day we got a call from a customer and they said, "Oh, there's a bug on the website. Here there are no contact information displayed in the footer. What's going on?" And we were wondering, okay, what's going on here? Because we tested this rather thoroughly and nothing actually could go wrong. And then we had a look at what they actually did. So they added a new domain to the system. Then they disabled all nodes in this domain except for the homepage, the audiologist search, their detail pages, and one product. So what they actually did was create a microsite to present one single product using our concept, which was actually not prepared for this, but it actually worked. So this is a completely new level of problem that can arise when using Neos with content dimensions. You might actually create a microsite framework by accident. So here are a few examples about how this could look like. On the left is the master site, and on the right is a variant from one of the members. So you can see there's some common elements like a news list and a call to action button to the shop, which I will be talking about in the next few slides. And above that, you can see individual content. So on the left is what the union provided, and on the right you see what the audiologist edited themselves. The second part of the project was a shop for all of them. About 80 of them joined this platform to create their own shops. There are 4,500 products there. And a product catalog, sellers, the checkout process, and rendering of everything is done in Neos. And a selection process for sellers is necessary at some point. For example, if you're on a product details page, you have to select one of the partners before you can go on with the checkout process. And this is basically the most important thing in this project because it's for our customer, the most important part are their partners or members of that union. So this could look like this. You're on this set details page, and you cannot add this product to the cart yet because no price has been specified because you didn't select one of the partners yet. So you get redirected to the search page. You select one of those which is most probably closest to you. This is then confirmed via flash message. You get a price shown, and now you can continue shopping. So one small but not negligible detail about this is that we used Magento for management of prices, carts, and orders. So this was lazily bootstrapped in the back end whenever necessary, but that became more and more seldom. There were custom price rules managed in a separate application, which is because all those partners are actually companies of their own, so they cannot have the same prices everywhere. There are some offices and state offices that don't like stuff like this. And we went over to calculating the prices actually in Neos, because as we found out rather soon, is that this amount of price calculation, Magento isn't made for this. So we reduced calculation time from 9 hours upwards to about somewhere below 10 seconds. What they also wanted to do is a customizable homepage, because they thought, oh, this works so nicely on our website. Can we have the same for our shop? And we were like, okay, let's be a bit careful. We're talking about 80 dimension values. And it's only for the homepage. So we came up with a different solution where there's some kind of homepage overlay that they can define individually. And the whole thing was basically done in 6 weeks by a SET team. That was actually fast, I think. So thank you for your attention. Here are the links to the websites we created. And if you're interested in doing something similar with content dimensions, there's a package inspired by this, but implemented in another project that helps you with custom dimension detection and resolution modes. Okay, thanks.